would say that if you didn't have an interest in the oil for use in the future, you could not speculate in it.
You would have to be a business that needs
that's right.
to buy oil.
That exactly is part of the Feinstein-Stevens bill.
Governor, at what point did you decide to back Stevens' plan? And does this mean that you will not have a long-term plan of your own?
We do have a long-term plan that is relevant to the state and what we have control over. And I decided to support his plan as soon as I heard about it because, again, he's got great points in here. As you can tell, he's very, very passionate about finding solutions to this energy crisis. Let me change the subject a bit there. He had mentioned something there that he perceived as being stupid. Let me tell you what I think is stupid, and I believe Americans would agree with me. What is stupid is having to send Secretary Bodman over to the Saudis to ask them to ramp up developments and ramp up an energy supply to be imported into our nation. Prior to that, a few weeks prior, we had to send our president over to ask him to ask them to ramp up development. He's talking about manipulation within the market. I want to talk about the market in terms of more supply getting in there. I do want to see more domestic, safe, stable, clean supplies of energy from our own country being able to feed hungry markets instead of, again, having to send our president to the Saudis to ask them to do that for us. So his concentration, as you can tell, is on the market, manipulation in there, speculators there. I want to concentrate on long, intermediate, short-term plans to get more supply into our markets.
Is it realistic to even talk about opening Anwar in the near future, given who the presidential nominees are going to be and the move to the country?
Yes, I think so. John Klein, McCain, he voted for the appropriation bill that contained the approval of Anwar. And I think he's a man that has the courage to change his position.
And he came around on OCS, of course, also. His position has evolved into more progress there. I anticipate the same with Anwar.
I think the American public is finally waking up to who's delayed it. Mm-hmm. Who's fought it now for 25 years? We've been fighting for domestic production for 25 years, and we've been opposed since Carter's day. Carter withdrew over 100 million acres of Alaska, and a lot of it was to prevent us from getting access to oil and gas. You cannot get water power, you can't get geothermal power, you can't get any of that power unless you have an enormous cash flow to finance it. And where is that going to come from? From the development of the oil and gas of the state. So what we want to do is dedicate that to assuring that those renewables, those alternative forms are in fact invested in, so in the long term, as the oil and gas runs out, we will have a state that has power, energy from all these other sources. It's going to take investment for a long period of time. But we have the ability to do it if we can get into the development of oil and gas now.
I'd just like to hear from each of you how you feel about the other. I think there's a sort of a perceived rift perception in Alaska that there's a rift between you two. The governor has made some statements against some of your earmarks. She said at the time your house was searched and we need to tell Alaskans more about kind of what's behind that. You haven't exactly had glowing endorsements of the GIA. What do you two think about each other and describe your relationship?
You can go first.
We've known each other for a long time. We've worked together for a long time. I've never known of any animosity between the two of us at all. We're each free to make comments about what the other does, and every once in a while she'll say I'm stupid, and that probably may be right.
Good morning to you all. I was just mentioning to a couple of my table mates here that this morning I'm watching C-SPAN, I'm watching these public television stations where it is showing that it seems to be at this time it's all Anwar all the time. It's all Alaska all the time. People are recognizing across our nation that Alaska has some solutions as we seek to find those solutions to the energy crisis that we're in. And it's going to get worse before it gets better unless we open up Anwar, unless we start tapping into the domestic supplies of energy that we know can be safely, responsibly, ethically developed. The price of oil and now gasoline, very subject and sensitive to events occurring outside the U.S. We've unfortunately, though, placed ourselves in this position of having to plead with suppliers in the Middle East to increase production. And how much nonsense is that, as Americans see that we have to send over Secretary Bodman and our president overseas to ask the Saudis to ramp up production of energy sources when again that we know we have those domestic clean supplies, safe supplies here.
You're here to hear a lot of good and inspiring information and learn why we're recommending that TC Alaska is ready to go in the gas mine process, ready to receive that license to build this long sought after project here in Alaska. I'm confident that with every minute that you spend with our gas line team and their array of world-class consultants, you're going to see evidence through hard facts and figures and data. You're going to understand the logic behind the recommendation to award TC Alaska that AGEA license.
So do you have any aspirations to be in a more national spotlight?
Well, you know, I'm a Republican, and I think that my name has been thrown out there because the Republican Party is finally recognizing we need some diversity on a ticket. You know, we can't just have, rich old white guys on the ticket. Not that there's anything wrong with the rich old white guys, but the ideals of the Republican Party are treating everyone equally, allowing individuals to make decisions, not a big government making decisions for you, allowing job opportunities for our families, and allowing the income earned from our families to be kept within the family to spend as they deem most wise. All those things that are ideals in the Republican Party and planks in the platform, they need to be articulated and really lived out by a more diverse group of leaders.
Now, you're in town for a conference on women.
Right. Newsweek has a conference on women in leadership, and Governor Napolitano from Arizona and I will be participating in that tonight.
We wanted actually to talk to you about the fact that there's a lot of news being made about you being a possible running mate for mm-hmm. Senator John McCain, and some have been questioning his age as well as ability to attract female voters and younger voters. How did it all come about that this your name was put on the list?
Well, I think there's a recognition in McCain's camp that there is that gap there that he has between maybe younger voters and female voters. So I think they're just putting their feelers out and looking for some qualified, enthusiastic potential candidates. And they're talking to all of us right now. So. No done deal there at all, not even close. In fact, I'm trying to deal in reality here. Reality is I really doubt that I'd be the one to be tapped. So, you know, we're just concentrating on those needs up in Alaska and how I can best serve in my home state.
Would you run as vice president?
Well, they mentioned my name. They also mentioned other governors' names, and I'm thankful for that because I do think there needs to be a governor on the ticket. A governor is there on the front line administering bureaucracy and setting good policy for the people whom they are serving. They know how to run government.
She's young, energetic, and I think she deserves to be considered. Approval rating of over 80% is widely seen as something of a phenomenon.
Because since being elected, I've asked to come over and get to visit our troops, get to show appreciation and support for our troops. Thank you, U.S. military. And I want to say hello to my son.
Keep that faith. Keep your courage. Stick together. Stay strong. Do not yield. Do not flinch. Stand up. We're Americans. We're Americans, and we'll never surrender. They will.
Now?
Yeah, you're rolling.
Canyon, hello. I'm Governor Sarah Palin. I just want to say hello to you, and you're lucky you have such a nice mama who's picking berries for you. Tell her to make you some blueberry pancakes. And I love your name, Canyon, and I look forward to meeting you in person someday. So have a good day, Canyon.